गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी स्टार्ट विथ योर एक्सरसाइज 2.2 एंड कंटिन्यू योर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. यू कैन सी द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. फाइंड द अमाउंट एक्यूमुलेटेड, फाइंड द अमाउंट एक्यूमुलेटेड आफ्टर 2 इयर्स इफ रुपीज 24,000 इन्वेस्टेड एवरी 6 मंथ एट द रेट ऑफ 12% पर एनम कंपाउंडेड हाफ ईयरली एंड इन दिस क्वेश्चन 1.06 रेस टू 4 1.2625 इज द गिवन वैल्यू. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन द डिफरेंट पार्ट इज गिवन कंपाउंडेड हाफ ईयरली. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन योर 24,000 इज द एन्यूटी विच इज इन्वेस्टेड एवरी हाफ ईयर. If n 2 years is there, so 2 years, in a 2 years, how many half years? 4. And if the rate is 12% per annum, so it comes to 6% half yearly. So just converted number of years into half years. So 2 years becomes 4 half year. So n is 4 and if rate is 12% per annum, it comes to rupees, n is, rate is 12%, 6% half yearly. So your I, 6 upon 100, 0.06. As usual, your common formula of accumulated A is equals to C upon 1 plus I. C, invested rupees 24,000, your I 0.06, 1 plus 0.06, your power N is here, 4. And one more thing, my dear student, you can easily understood, if you forget to convert this, then also you can connect with this value. If by mistake we forgot to convert 2 years into 4 half year, rate half yearly 6%, then also you can easily understood the given value and the formula value. Your 24,000 upon 0.06 and this value 1.2625 minus 1, your A 24,000 upon 6 into 100 into 0.2625, this value. Six into 1, 2, 3, 4, your decimal value. By doing the cancellation, if we multiply 2625 into 4 into 10, it comes to rupees 1 lakh. Just calculate this. You will get the value of A, 1 lakh 5,000. Understood this? Okay. Your next question number 4. Find the amount of accumulated value after 1 year of annuity immediate if rupees 10,000 invested every quarter at the rate of 16% per annum compounded quarterly. If you read this question properly, last question it is compounded half yearly and in this question we compounded quarterly. Quarterly means 4 times in a year. If half yearly, 2 times. Quarterly, 4 times. So this 10,000 is your annuity and 16% per annum. So 4% per quarter. Rate divided by 4 and it is your I. If 1 year is given, in a year, how many quarters? 4. So your R becomes 4% per annum and your N is 4 quarters. Right. So as a required A accumulated value, C upon I is 0.04. 1 plus 0.04 your N is 4 times minus 1. If we connect directly with the given 1 plus 0.04, 1.04 value comes to 1.1699 minus 1. So your required value of A 0.1699. Into 4 and 25, 1699 into 8 is already counted, 42,475. So 1699 into 25, this is your required value. The difference is only here. If it is half yearly in the last question, multiply, divide by 2. If it is quarterly, divide by 4, multiplied by 4. Understood? Now your question number 5. Find the present value of annuity immediate of rupees 36,000 invested every year for 3 years and the rate of interest is 9% compounded annually. This is the first question we calculate for the present value. Okay. So 36,000 per annum, N is 3 years given, rate is 9%, so I comes to 0.09. So your required formula of the present value, C upon I, 36,000 upon I 0.09 and 1 minus 1 plus I 0.09 and your power N is minus 3. So your present value comes to 36,000 upon 0.09, 1.09 minus 3, 0.7722. Your present value 36,000 0.09 into your 1 minus 0.7722 comes to 0.2278. 1 minus 0.7722, your 36,000 2278 100. So your present value 2278 into 4 into 10 comes to 91,120, right? So you can count the present value with the help of your formula of C upon I, 1 minus 1 plus I raised to minus I. Understood? Your next question number 7. A lady plans to save for her daughter's marriage. She wishes to accumulate a sum of rupees 4,64,100 at the end of 4 years. What should she invest every year? She get interest of 10% compounded annually. See, in this question, lady wants to accumulate. She wants 4,64,100 in future after 4 years. And she wants to invest some amount now. So your C annuity is missing and your accumulated value 4,64,100 is already given. So rate is 10% and N is 4 years. Your accumulated value 4,64,100. Your C is missing and I 0.1. 1 plus 0.1, your nth power is 4 minus 1. C upon 0.1. This value is already given, 1.4641 minus 1, 464,100, 0.1 and 0.4641. We are transferring all the values from left to right or right to left, whatever is the applicable. A 10 and these 4 zeros for the 4641 is 0. By doing the cancellation, 4641 tens are and 10,010 is your 1 leg. So, as per the requirement of question, we want 4,64,100 after 4 years. So, how much C invest from this now? So, C invest 1 lakh rupees per year. For how many years? 4 years. So, required annuity. Annuity is 1 lakh. Understood? Your question number 10. Find the number of years for which an annuity of rupees 500 is paid at the end of every year. If the accumulated amounts work out to be 1,655 when the interest is compounded annually at 10%. See, this is the again different question, because in this question, see, annuity is 500 rupees. A, your accumulated value rupees 1,655. Rate 10% I comes to 0.01. So we want number of years. Here N is the missing value. So A is 1,655 is C 500. Your I is 0.1. 1 plus your I is 0.1. This N is missing. So 1,655 into 0.1 upon 500, 1.1 raised to N minus 1. This is the remaining part. 1,655 into 1 upon 500 into 10 is equals to 1.1 N minus 1. If we calculate 1,655 divided by 5,000, it comes to 0.331. You can count in the rough work also. Divide karna hai. Left to right 1 add karna hai. 1.1 raised to N. If we add 1.331, 1.1 raised to N. See, whenever index in the sense power is missing, we compare and calculate with the base. Here the base is 1.1. So obviously this value 1.331 is also having some calculation, some relation with 1.1. If we calculate 1.1 square 1.1 cube, so you can count 1.1 square is 1.21 and 1.1 cube is 1.331. Here 1.1 and the power. If we compare, by comparing 1.1 cube, 1.1 nth power, by using the rules of indices, when the base are same, your powers are also same. So your n is equals to 3. And we require how many years? So n is equals to 3 years is your required answer. Again, see, if any question we are not solving in the online part, so don't worry, these all questions are compulsory. Not a single question is omitted, but the remaining question we solve in the classroom lecture. Even if you have any doubt in this kind of question, then also don't worry, don't panic. We all solve again this question during the lecture. Understood? Because I always discuss this lockdown is temporary, but your education is permanent. So this temporary basis, we are solving your problem of education. So don't worry, we are always with you. Understood? Fine. Now your question number 11. Find the accumulated value of annuity due of rupees 1000 for 3 years at the rate of 10% compounded annually. See, this is the first question. We count for annuity due, and in this question, 1000 is your annuity, 3 years is the N and I is 0.1, and we require accumulated value. In annuity due, accumulated value is denoted by A days, and the formula is same as per the immediate annuity, but in annuity due, we invested amount in the beginning. So we got little bit extra interest. So the extra wala part hai, which is 1 plus I. So this part is same. This much we add because the accumulated value we require for annuity due. By substituting the values, C 1000, I 0.1, I 0.1. By using the 1.1 cube, this value we are given in the question, 1.331. Now your required value, by removing the decimal point, so your 331 into 11, 3641. So your accumulated value rupees 3641. So as usual, जैसे आप earlier basis पे count करते थे, we use that similar method for annuity due also. Understood? Your question number 14. An annuity immediate is to be paid for some years. At 12% per annum, the present value of annuity is 10,000 and the accumulated value is rupees 20,000. Find the amount of each annuity payment. See, in this question, first of all, your type is annuity immediate. Your type is annuity immediate. Present value 10,000, accumulated value 20,000, and what is the rate? Rate is 12%. So I comes to 0.12. And we require payment of annuity, which is C. So if we have P, if we have A, and we require C, so we use the relation between P, A and C. This is the formula. 1 upon P minus 1 upon A equals to I upon C. We use the value of 1 upon 10,000, 1 upon 20,000, 0.12 upon C. See, in this type, we want to LCM on the left side. So 10,000 into 2, 20,000 into 1. Mommy. 0.12 upon C. If calculating 1 upon 20,000, 0.12 upon C by using the cross multiplication, upon 100. So your annuity comes to rupees 2400. So your annuity 12 into 200 comes to rupees 2400. Understood? This is also different formula which we use the relation between P, A and C. Whichever value is missing out of these three, P, A, C, we use this formula. Understood?